Hello, welcome back to my second channel. I haven't really done any repairs on this channel. It's not the sort of place where I normally do this sort of thing, but I'm a little bit pushed for time, so I haven't really got time to go into all of the in-depth stuff. Not that I go in-depth very much on my channel, but I usually edit a little bit more, so this is going to be more of a rough and ready thing. But the thing is, I have these toast racks to repair. I've already done two of them and they were quite boring. These two here are all finished and they were quite boring. In fact, one of them just worked. This one just worked. I plugged it in, it was fine. It was probably the capacitors were a little bit needed a bit of conditioning, so that one just worked. This one I replaced TR4 and the voltage regulator and it sprang back to life and is perfect. So they're done. These were all sent over to me by Paul Universal Retro Boss, as usual. And we've got this one. And this one has a corrupted display. I'll show you that in a second. And I thought I would quickly do a repair on this one because it's a little bit more interesting. I would probably have, if I had a bit more time, have made this into a full video with all of the other toast rack repairs, because I've got these and somebody sent me a toast rack as well, which I'm going to make a separate video about because that one's really, really interesting. But that'll have to wait until things have settled down at home. But this one is actually a bit more interesting and I really wanted to share it with you because it's one of the ones where I found the problem by working through the logic of the situation. It's probably easier if I show you. So this is where I started. Let me switch this on and I can show you the corrupted display. Now, if I plug in the diagnostic cartridge, you can see underneath all of the wires and everything that it is actually running and it's making all the right noises and everything. But it keeps cycling back round. Yeah, it's not actually telling me anything. Oh, so yeah, so look, it has actually rebooted itself and started again. So it's not working properly. It's running code, so this tells me a few things. Now, you can see on here I've ticked the ULA. That's been tested in another machine, and the ROM has been tested in another machine. So both of those are known good. The CPU is running code, so I think it's probably okay, which leaves the memory and the ZTX8401, or in this case the PCF1306P, which is the glue logic for the memory. You first saw that in the issue 6 48K Spectrums. It's the one that I've made a modern replacement for in the Spectrum that went missing. We'll get to that. The first thing I did was test things like the data lines, and they all gave the expected results on across all. There are 16 chips in here, 16 RAM chips across here, these two here and these 14 here, and all of the data lines are good. And then I went through the address lines, let's go that one and that one and that one. So, and they were all good until I got down to address line 7, which you can see doesn't look quite right on this bank. Now, there are two banks in the 128K spectrum. There's these 8 chips here up from IC6 to IC13 are one bank. And then these 8 chips here from IC17 to, or ancient, in fact, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, and 22 are the other bank, the second bank. Now, if I go to that same address line 7, there's nothing on that one at all, just some interference. So you can see it's half there on one bank and not on the other bank. Okay, so if we go and have a look at the schematics, so we've got the ZTX8401 here, Z80 is here, the ROM is here, and there's one bank, that's that first, oh, that's the bank on the right, and that's the bank on the left of memory. Now the address lines, so if we look at the memory first, so address line 7 is there, and that also goes over here to the ULA. We know that that's good, so I can ignore that side. So where's address line 7? MA7 is address line 7, which pin 26 goes to there. But it's not the only place that you see address line 7. So you see it over on the CPU, which we think is running, and on the ROM. So address line 7 is here, but we know the ROM's okay. The CPU, we can test that pin 37 on the CPU. Let's have a look at that one. Yeah, pin 37, which is the fourth one down on the right here. So it's 40, 39, 38, 37 is there. So we know it's good on the CPU. So let's follow it across to the ROM, where it is pin 3 on the ROM. But we think the ROM is okay, but let's check it. Yep, and it's there on the ROM. And it goes into the ZX8401 or the PCF1306P on pin 3. So we can check that here. And there it is. But it comes out of the ZX8401 on pin, address line 7, pin 26. So you've got 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. And there, we've just got a high. Is there anything between pin 26 or address line 7 on the ZX8401 just goes to... It actually just goes to that bank of memory first. So I am a little bit confused. I think, because I don't think it's the ULA. I don't think it's, oh no, this is the bank of, yeah, this is the bank of memory that is bad. So it's either the ZX8401 or a memory chip over here has failed. So I'm going to quickly just scan through all of the other chips just to see if there's anything corrupt in these ones. So everything looks good, as far as I can see, on all of the address lines and various other lines there. So I'm going to take out the ZX8401, and then we'll see where we stand and test it in another board. If I've got something else I can test it in. Yes, I have. No damage. Phew. So, does this work or not? It's the question. I need to find a computer I can test it in. This is a 128K plus 2 grey. Let's not plug that in yet. Let's not plug anything in yet. This is the chip I just extracted from the 128K. And this is the same chip. Let's try it in this known good machine. One thing to note here, all the chips are oriented the wrong way around, which is really annoying. Damn it, it works. But does it work fully? going to work. So it's something on the other side of the ZTX8401, which is going to be a RAM chip. I don't think there's any logic sits in between that and the memory. Yeah, that's passed. That's good enough. Just for curiosity's sake, I'll put this chip in here and test it. Once I've put a socket in. Okay, so I've put a socket into the ZTX8401 and I've put the ZTX8401 from the other plus two gray in here and does exactly the same thing. So it's memory, but how do I track down which one of these is causing the problem? I really don't know. I thought this was going to be a fun, interesting video. Looking at the memory, so the right bank is warmer. This is probably more to do with the fact that I've just soldered something in here. Nothing looks bad. That ULA is already at 51 degrees. I was hoping this would be a simple fix, but looks like I'm going to have to come back to this. Boo. I came quite close to giving up on this one, but I'm glad I didn't. I persevered, and it's partly down to me being bloody-minded and stubborn. So as you can see, a few of the chips are now socketed. When I walked away, I just assumed that it was one of the RAM chips. And my intention was to start at this end and work my way along the RAM chip, socketing each one and testing it in my chip tester. And I got as far as two before I got bored of that. And then I started thinking, well, there are other things attached to the address bus that are attached to address line 7 in particular, that it could be that I haven't explored yet. I didn't think it was the CPU. I did remove the AY sound chip and it wasn't that. I did try just freeing up that single leg on its own, but all of the chips on this board have been stuffed into the holes really hard before they were soldered. So it was impossible to do that little trick that Happy Little Diodes has featured on recent videos, where he desolders the pin in place and just maneuvers it so that it's not actually touching, but it's still there, but it's not actually touching. So you can separate it, isolate it from the rest of the circuit, which is a really neat trick. But unfortunately, it didn't work in this instance. But go and watch Happy Little Diodes because he's brilliant. So it wasn't the AY sound chip that was causing the problem. Without that in circuit, I was still getting the same corruption on screen. I then started thinking, hang on a second. So address line 7 is like 0 to 7. It could be that a logical arrangement of chips, like on the 48K spectrum, address line 7 would be a certain IC. So I started to think, well, it's going to be either the first one or the last one in a bank. I didn't know which one it was because the schematics just shows the banks of address chips as one block and doesn't separate them into the, you know, and say this address line goes to this one, but which is kind of sensible because all of the address lines go to all of the chips. So I took out this IC here. It wasn't that either. And then I went back to the schematics and had a little look. So let's go to the schematics. So here I had a look at where address line 7 actually interacts with any IC. So there it is on the ZTX8401 on pin 26. So I've tested this chip. That was the one I took out before. and it comes across here and it goes into this bank of ICs here, which is the first bank of DRAM chips on pin 9 there. It doesn't say which chip, but I suppose it's just pin 9 on all of them. That would make sense. And I, in fact, yes, that's the one that I've been testing and seeing on the scope is showing a bad reading. And then over here, address line 7 on pin 9 again is not actually attached to the, these two banks are not attached together, which also makes sense in a way, but we'll come to that. And over here, the ULA has address line 7 on it here on pin 11. And I took a reading on that one with the scope and it was showing a bit of a bad, well, it was just a bad signal. So that one is attached to this bank, and this bank IC6 to IC13 is the left-hand bank over here, and IC6 to IC13, and this bank here, IC15 to 22, is the other side. So this 6 here and these two here. What's happening here, I think, is these two ICs up here are actually, I mean, they are, this one says it's got bank written on it, and I think these are to do with bank switching. But if you have a look over here, coming out of the ULA on pin 11 is address line 7, which is attached down here. But if you follow it across here, it doesn't go straight through. It's the only one that goes up here to IC30, which is this 74LS157. And I scoped the pins on this one, and to be frank, it was a mess. So I popped that one out, put it in my TL-866, and I'll show you a quick screen grab of that. Yeah, it's failed. This is the culprit. I put a new chip in here, switched it on, and boom! It's got horrible jail bars on it, but it's working. So yeah, 3 working toast racks for Paul Universal Retro Bus. I do have another one. I got a package. I'm going to open that in a separate video, so watch out for that, also on the second channel. But I've got some other stuff coming that I want to unbox at the same time as that. So that's going to be a little bit extra time, and I need to edit this video. So anyway, that worked. If I'd have just followed my logic just one more stage further, I'd have looked so much more smart and cleverer. Right, so thanks for watching that. I was tempted to put this on the main channel, but I'm not too desperate about releasing regularly on the main channel at the moment, because there is going to be a small break while some things that are happening here at home. It does mean that I'm not going to be making so many videos, maybe not very many at all, for at least a few weeks. But my computer just boomed at me. But I will be in here and I will be communicating on Discord. And it's always been the best place to contact me and to interact with me and everybody else that is on there as well. But there is a great little community that's built up on there, so in the first part of this year especially. And I'm really proud of the way it's going, and the people on there are just lovely and super helpful and supportive. So if you want to be part of that and come and have a chat, I'm going to be on there a lot more than I am on social media. I'm not on social media at all really anymore. It served its purpose. Yeah, thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next videos. There will be little videos coming out, but just not very many. Or there may be loads. I don't know.